We all know the Premier League is littered with Champions League winners, and there seem to be rumours linking teams with moves for even more every day of the week. But let's take a look at every club in the Championship and see what players who have lifted the European Cup have played for these sides. Although admittedly, while these players were at the clubs when they won the Champions League, some of them didn't even make it to the bench. Aston Villa, Martin Laursen. Yes, the most obvious choice is the current club captain. He probably goes to sleep in his Chelsea kit from that night. But we'll go back a bit further to another Champions League winning defender. Danish defender Martin Laursen lifted the cup with AC Milan in 2003 when they beat Juventus on penalties at Old Trafford, before ending up at Aston Villa within a year to see out the remaining 5 years of his career, wisely ducking out before the club basically imploded on itself. Sorry Villa fans, but how else do you explain having a 31-year-old hamburger enthusiast on the payroll? Barnsley, Ross Turnbull. Yeah, we're only two clubs in and we're already stretching the boat way out. Ross Turnbull contributed as much to Chelsea's Champions League triumph in 2012 as my dog Scrappy, and he's been dead for 16 years. Turnbull, an unused goalkeeper, watched his colleagues pick up the trophy before getting released the following year. He's since had a spell at Barnsley. It did not go too well, but at least he has that medal to show the grandkids. Let's just hope they don't ask to see his YouTube highlight reel. Birmingham, Alexander Hleb. Considering Alexander Hleb pines for Arsenal in every interview he does these days, and the fact he's had 12 moves in the decade since leaving the club, the Belarusian is turning into that lonely old divorcee who goes out every weekend running through the partners in a bid to forget the one that got away. No disrespect, Birmingham, but the fact Hleb ended up at St Andrews less than a year after lifting the Champions League with Barcelona over Manchester United in 2009 proves that his new camp move was not exactly a success. Bolton, Fernando Hierro. Some of these clubs I'm struggling, but with Bolton they could almost field a team of former Champions League winners. Fernando Hierro spent 14 seasons at the Bernabeu, winning the Champions League 3 times, but I guess it was always his dream to play for Big Sam Allardyce and alongside Kevin Davies and Nicky Hunt. He retired at the Reebok in 2005. One season in Etihad's dressing room was enough for him. Brentford, Josh McCracken. I'm reaching, I know I am. Josh McCracken putting on his CV that he's a Champions League winner is like me writing on mine that I'm a journalist. But hey, he was at Stamford Bridge in 2012 when they played Bayern. Actually, you know what? I'm not even good. Yeah, okay. McCracken did not win it. I have failed with Brentford, alright? I can't find one. Moving on. Bristol City, Andy Cole. Andy Cole could have featured in this list for about half these clubs, but we'll go with Bristol City, where he netted 20 goals in 41 games back in the early 90s after being spat out by Arsenal. He, of course, went on to lift the Champions League in 1999 when Ole Gunnar Solskjaer made Bayern Munich fans worldwide contemplate whether or not they should drown themselves in their pints of German beer. Burton Albion, Stephen Warnock. Stephen Warnock. Jesus, there's some real European heavyweights in this list, isn't there? Well, sorry lads, believe it or not, you won't find many Galacticos frothing at the mouth to book a one-way ticket to Burton. Stephen Warnock was part of the Liverpool squad that won the competition during the 04-05 season. I mean, he was a third choice left back behind Gian Anderisa and, God help us all, Jimmy Traore, so I'm not sure how much help he was. He's currently at Burton Albion. Cardiff City, Tom Heaton. Cardiff City aren't in the business of employing too many former Champions League winners. Pipe down Craig, he lost that game. We're just going to have to go with Tom Heaton. Another goalkeeper who contributed to his Champions League success as much as my local postman, and I don't even have a postman. Derby County, Fabrizio Ravanelli. Fabrizio Ravanelli might be better known for his time in England with Middlesbrough, but he also knocked in a few goals for Derby County from 2001 to 2003. Did not stop them getting relegated from the top flight, mind. Quite a fall from winning the Champions League for Juventus in 1996, when he even scored against Ajax in the final. Fulham, Edwin van der Sar. Edwin van der Sar has won 2 Champions League titles, both 13 years apart, one with Ajax and the other with Manchester United. His sandwiching spell at Fulham, where he spent 4 seasons, he could hardly have been blamed for thinking his time in Europe's top competition had passed him by. But Edwin, when Roy Carroll was still doing this, there were always going to be top clubs who were going to give you a ring. Hull City, John Welsh. I know, okay? I know. John Welsh was at Liverpool when they won the Champions League in 2005 and went on to play 4 years for Hull City, but yeah, don't worry. I know. Ipswich Town, Ivan Campo. Ivan Campo was a bit of a cult hero at Bolton, having spent 6 years there, so when we think of him in England, we tend to forget the 17 appearances for Ipswich Town under Roy Keane, a man 3 years older than him, during the 08-09 season. The Spaniard actually won the Champions League a year after Keane, and unlike the Irishman, he was actually on the pitch, playing all 90 minutes against Valencia in the final. Leeds United, Roque Jr. If you're signing a player who is fresh from lifting the World Cup and Champions League, both within 12 months of each other, you'd be expecting to bring in a player who didn't have the ball control of a drunk kid. Roque Jr. arrived at Elland Road on loan from AC Milan in 2003, and by God there was excitement. He then helped the team concede 24 goals in his 7 appearances. Good lord, he was awful. Middlesbrough, Michael Reisiger. There were a few candidates, but we'll go for Michael Reisiger. The Dutchman won the Champions League in 1995 when a teenage Patrick Kluivert helped Ajax down AC Milan. 9 years later, and Reisiger was in the northeast of England for a season. Funnily enough, so was Kluivert. Millwall, Teddy Sheringham. Veering back to the night of 99, as we all know, Teddy Sheringham was the one who grabbed the late equaliser against Bayern Munich, setting the scene for Solskjaer's Spurs' punted finish. The former England striker, recently sacked by Atletico del Calcata, started his career at Millwall though, scoring 93 goals in 220 games for the Lions, while the fans no doubt showed their appreciation by stabbing each other with broken glass. Norwich City, Thomas Helveg. The summer of 2004 saw Norwich City and Aston Villa go head-to-head in who could raid the benches of the Milan clubs for a Danish centre-back. With Larsson off to Villa, Thomas Helveg was brought to Norwich from Inter Milan. He'd actually spent 5 years with the other Milan though, and won the Champions League in 2003. Didn't do much in Norwich though, playing 20 games as they sunk into the Championship. Not even Delia and her Sherry-inspired team talks to save them. Nottingham Forest, Roy Keane. He may have missed the 1999 Champions League final through suspension, so according to him, he didn't win anything, but sorry Roy Keane, yes you did. QPR, Julio Cesar. Like Bolton, QPR went about assembling a squad littered with Champions League winning experience. Unlike Bolton, these were players who traded their ambition for a paycheck the moment they walked into Loftus Road. Cue relegation. Julio Cesar had lifted the Champions League with Inter Milan in 2010, and within 2 years he was being paraded at QPR. To show the lack of forward planning in that club's transfers that summer, he was the second goalkeeper to have been signed in 6 weeks, and Rob Green had no intention of sitting on the bench quietly. Preston North End, David Beckham. Yeah, Preston sounds like the kind of fancy name that David Beckham would probably give to his next child. Well, if his wife wasn't soaring her way to the menopause, that is. As we know, Beckham was a Champions League winner in 1999 and has played for some of the biggest clubs in the world. Man United, Real Madrid, AC Milan, PSG, and Preston North End, on loan for 5 games in 1994. He even scored direct from a corner kick. Reading, Ryan Bertrand. When Bayern Munich fans saw 22-year-old Ryan Bertrand starting at left wing in their patched-up Champions League final lineup against the Germans 6 years ago, you could hardly have blamed them for dying of laughter. Either that or diving straight on Wikipedia to find out who the hell he was. After all, he'd only made 8 top-flight appearances in his entire career up to that point. Well, the apparent move of lunacy paid off, and the Blues lifted the trophy in penalties, making a Champions League winner out of the man who 2 years earlier was on loan at Reading in the Championship. Sheffield Wednesday, Chris Kirkland. Okay, technically Chris Kirkland did not actually get a medal from Istanbul. Of course, he missed out on sitting on the bench during the final because he was injured. Sure, what else would he be doing? Apparently, Scott Carson tried to give his medal to Kirkland, since Kirkland had played more than him in that campaign, but he still said no. Kirkland went on to spend 3 seasons with Sheffield Wednesday. Sheffield United, Gary Cahill. Not many people make better mid-season decisions than Gary Cahill when he traded near certain relegation for a double cup glory with Chelsea. The former Aston Villa centre-half had spent time on loan at Sheffield United 4 years earlier, with the club having just been relegated. Not many people can say they played with both Didier Drogba and John Stead. Sunderland, John O'Shea. There were a few options here, you know, since Roy Keane did try to draft in half the players from that squad back in 1999, with most of them almost needing Zimmer frames in 2007. We'll go with John O'Shea though. A winner thanks to John Terry's slip in 2008, he signed for Sunderland in 2011, where he's made over 200 appearances. So used to winning every week, I can't imagine that it's been an easy adjustment for him, especially when he would have had to look to his left and seen Titus Bramble on arrival. Wolves, Dennis Irwin. One of the most understated men of football, you certainly wouldn't have seen Dennis Irwin out at 3 a.m. wrapped in wags, getting fancy haircuts, and as far as dabbing goes, he probably still doesn't know what it is. Anyway, the former Manchester United left back obviously lifted the cup in 1999 and went on to finish up his career with Wolves, earning promotion in 2003. Let's just ignore him finishing his career in a relegation.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.